Module 7, Section 10.4, Trigonometric Polar Form of Complex Numbers. We're going to look at the complex plane and vector representations. We'll call the horizontal axis the real axis, and the vertical axis the imaginary axis. And now, complex numbers can be graphed in this complex plane. The sum of two complex numbers can be represented graphically by the vector that is the resultant of the sum of vectors corresponding to the two numbers. Here in this example, we want to find the sum of 6 minus 2i and negative 4 minus 3i. We'll graph both complex numbers and their resultant. So let's add them as we would normal complex numbers. We add the real parts, so 6 plus negative 4 will give us 2, and we add the imaginary parts, negative 2 plus negative 3i will give us negative 5i. So our answer is 2 minus 5i. Now when we graph them, 6 minus 2i, remember that our imaginary axis is here, and our real axis is here, so we have 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and down 2 for I. So here we have 6 minus 2i. And then negative 4 and negative 3i would be here. And the resultant was 2, negative 5i. And we can see when we make our parallelogram that this is our resultant. In this graph, we see the complex number x plus yi that corresponds to the vector OP. The relationship among our values, we have that x is r cosine of theta, y is r sine of theta, r is the square root of x squared plus y squared, and the tangent of theta is y over x if x is not equal to 0. Substituting x equal r cosine of theta and y equal r sine of theta into x plus yi gives x plus yi as r cosine of theta plus r sine of theta I. And we can factor out r, and we'll get r times cosine of theta plus I sine of theta. This expression is called the trigonometric form or polar form of the complex number x plus yi. We have the following notation. The cosine of theta plus I sine of theta is sometimes written in shorthand form as cis of theta. Using this notation, we can rewrite our form as r cis of theta. The number r is called the modulus or absolute value of the complex number x plus yi. The angle theta is called the argument of the complex number x plus yi. Let's look at the following example. We want to express 2 cosine of 300 degrees plus I sine of 300 degrees in rectangular form. First thing we need to do is evaluate the cosine and sine of 300 degrees. So let's look at our coordinate plane. 300 degrees will be in quadrant 4. So we draw our reference angle, which will be 360 minus 300, or 60 degrees. And we see that our triangle, if we recall, will be square root of 3 over 2, and in this case it's negative, 1 half here, and 1. So 2 cosine of 300 degrees plus I sine of 300 degrees will be equal to 2 times the cosine of 300 degrees would be the same as the cosine of our reference angle, or 60 degrees here, which would be the adjacent over the hypotenuse, or our x value, so we have 1 half, plus I times our sine of 300, which would be the opposite over the hypotenuse, or our y value, so it's negative square root of 3 over 2. So 2 times 1 half is 1, and 2 times negative square root of 3 over 2 is negative square root of 3, so we have I square root of 3 here. If 1 minus I square root of 3 is our rectangular form. Now let's look at our graphing calculator solution. You can type it in using I. If you notice on your calculator where the decimal button is, above it in orange is the little letter I, so you press second and the decimal to put it in there. You'll also want to make sure that you are in complex mode, so let me show you how to do that. On your calculator, press mode and go all the way down to near the bottom where it says real. Make sure that it's on A plus BI, which we are here. So you simply type in your trigonometric form and it gives you the rectangular form, although we don't have it written in square roots or radicals. But notice that when we take the negative square root of 3, we get our value they gave us in decimal. When converting from rectangular to trigonometric form, the first step is to sketch a graph of the number in the complex plane. Secondly, we want to find r by using the equation square root of x squared plus y squared. Thirdly, we find theta by using the equation tangent of theta is y over x, where x is not equal to 0, and choosing the quadrant we found when we graphed in step 1. In this example, we want to write each complex number in trigonometric form. First, we'll do the negative square root of 3 plus I, and we want to use radians. So in this case, x will be equal to negative square root of 3, and y will be 1, since there's no value coefficient for I. So r is the square root of x squared plus y squared, or the square root of negative square root of 3 squared plus 1 squared. So I have the square root of 3 plus 1, which is the square root of 4, or 2 for r. And then the tangent of theta is y over x, or 1 over negative square root of 3, which is equal to negative square root of 3 over 3 when we rationalize our denominator. So we want to take the tangent inverse of negative square root of 3 over 3 to get theta. And on our calculator, we want to make sure that we're in radian mode. So here we are, and we click clear. Then we take the tangent inverse of negative square root of 3 over 3. And remember, to get our value with pi in a fraction form, we're going to divide by pi and convert to a fraction, and then add pi back in the numerator. So we end up with negative pi over 6. Now this value is in quadrant 4, but if we look at the graph of our original complex number, we see that we need to be in quadrant 2. So what we'll do is we'll add pi to our value, which is in quadrant 4 down here, in order to get the angle in quadrant 2, which would be 5 pi over 6. So our trigonometric or polar form, which is r cis of theta, would be 2 CIS of 5 pi over 6, or 2 times the cosine of 5 pi over 6 plus I sine of 5 pi over 6. Now let's convert negative 3i, but we want to use degrees. Notice there was no real part, so we have 0 as our real part, minus 3i. So x is 0, and y is negative 3. R is the square root of x squared plus y squared. So we have the square root of 0 squared plus negative 3 squared. So it's the square root of 9, or 3. The tangent of theta is y over x, so we have negative 3 over 0. This is undefined, but let's look at the graph. When we graph negative 3i, we see we're on our y-axis, and our angle there is 3 pi over 2, or 270 degrees, since we were asked to use degrees. So our angle theta is 270 degrees. And we have that negative 3i, then, is 3 CIS of 270 degrees, or 3 times the cosine of 270 degrees, plus I sine of 270 degrees. Let's look at multiplying complex numbers in rectangular form. We multiply the following and we FOIL it out, we'll get negative 2 square root of 3 plus 2i minus 2i times 3 plus 2i squared square root of 3. So we have negative 2 square root of 3 plus 2i minus 6i. Remember that I squared is negative 1, so we have plus negative 2 square root of 3. So that gives us negative 4 square root of 3 minus 4i. Now when we multiply numbers in trigonometric form, complex numbers, we have the following product theorem. If we have R1 cosine of theta 1 plus I sine of theta 1, and R2 cosine of theta 2 plus I sine of theta 2, that are two complex numbers, then when we multiply them, we see that our answer will be our R values multiplied plus the cosine of the sum of our angles plus I sine of the sum of our angles. So let's use the product theorem in the following example. We want to find the product of the following two trigonometric forms. So what we'll do is we'll multiply our R values, or 3 times 2. Then we'll have the cosine of the sum of our angles, so 45 degrees plus 135 degrees, plus I sine of the sum of our angles. So we get 6 times the cosine of 180 degrees plus I sine of 180 degrees. Now, when you evaluate 180 degrees, the cosine and the sine, you'll see that the cosine of 180 degrees is negative 1 plus I times the sine of 180 degrees is 0. So our imaginary part will disappear. We have 6 times negative 1, or negative 6. Now let's look at quotients of complex numbers in trigonometric form. First, the rectangular form of the quotient is given here. We see that when we are doing the quotient of two complex numbers, we'll multiply the numerator and the denominator by the complex conjugate, which is our complex number changed the sign in the middle. So we've changed just to subtraction here. We FOIL out the top, and we see we get the following when we FOIL. When we combine like terms and change I squared to negative 1, we'll get negative 8i in the numerator, and in the denominator, we'll get 16. So we end up with negative 1/2i. We end up with the following quotient theorem when we're dividing complex numbers in trigonometric form. Notice that our two numbers, we simply end up with the division of our r values, and then the cosine of our two angles being subtracted, plus I sine of our two angles being subtracted. Let's use the quotient theorem in the following example. We want to find the quotient of our two trigonometric forms, and we'll write the result in rectangular form. So we will divide our r values, and then we take the cosine of our values subtracted, so negative 60 degrees minus 150 degrees, plus I sine of our values subtracted. So we end up with 2 times the cosine of negative 210 degrees plus I sine of negative 210 degrees. We want to evaluate the cosine of negative 210 degrees. First thing we need to do is take negative 210 degrees and add 360 to get our coterminal angle, which will be 150 degrees. So we see that we're in quadrant 2, so negative 210 degrees, or 150 degrees, is here. We find our reference angle, which will be 30 degrees, and our triangle will then be 1/2, square root of 3 over 2, which is negative here, and 1. So the cosine is our x value, or our adjacent, over our hypotenuse, so we get negative square root of 3 over 2, plus I times the sine, which would be our y value, or the opposite over the hypotenuse, which is 1/2. And we'll distribute 2 to each value here, so we get negative square root of 3 plus I.